Hello all, welcome back. I'm Pavan Sriram. In this video, I'm talking with Dr. Paras Mehta, who is currently working as a full stack developer, one of the most sought of profession across the globe, and also his entrepreneurial journey about India to Germany.
So Paras, tell me about yourself.
Yes, I think I have a relatively diverse background. I have spent, so I'm originally from India, and I did this course in Erasmus Mundus, where we lived around in different countries. And then I moved to Germany to do my PhD. So I have spent a lot of time in academic research. And I worked as a data scientist, and now I'm working as a full stack developer. So I have moved around a lot. I also tried to start my own company. I have done different things, and somehow now I'm here in Berlin, Germany.
So what's been your main inspiration trying to do work related to data science or full stack development?
I think there are really good problems. There are very interesting things that you can do these days with data science and software development. You can tackle problems which have real impact. So, I mean, if you look at fields like medicine these days or healthcare, there is a huge impact of data analysis, of machine learning, of software development on these fields. There are applications which could not be imagined a few years ago. And I think that's kind of my motivation for working in this field, to try to solve real problems rather than invent problems myself and then try to solve them.
And for those of you, for those who are listening into this conversation, what's your message for people who are interested to pursue a career in data science or in full stack development?
I think my main message would be to basically not stop learning. I think these are fields where there is a lot going on at the moment. You have to be open to, for example, keep taking online courses or participate in online competitions on Kaggle and websites like that. Basically learn from how other people solve problems. Try to see what other people have done on GitHub and things like that. Learn from how they solve problems and try to do that yourself. Basically, as much as hands-on experience as possible, that's always the best in any field, I think.
Mm. Yeah. And you talked about your journey. You've been probably, 50 countries, maybe even more. and then you've worked and lived in at least 6 or 7 of them in that period. So what's your message for people who are kind of looking into studying abroad or wanting to have some kind of mobility experience?
I mean, I would recommend it any day. I think it's an eye-opener. It makes you a better person. I think mobility is good for this society in general. You will make great memories. You will learn a lot. You will come in contact with really interesting people. I would say always, really, whenever you get a chance, don't miss it and study abroad, go abroad, try different things.
Just briefly talk about your current experience. Now, how do you manage your time with having a full-time job in Berlin and then your new venture? And what's this new venture all about also?
It's a lot of sacrifice on sleep, I have to say. But I really enjoy it. So I have, at the moment, I have a website and a podcast for people from other countries. So for example, from India, who look to move to Germany and build a career and, start living here. So I do a lot of things. I post career opportunities and career tips. And I also interview people about their experiences and advice. I find it really interesting. And that's why I think I managed to spend so much time on it and do the job as well. Because if you're just enjoying something, I think you really don't take it as work.
So for somebody who is studying in IT or computer science and they want to move into data science or full stack development, how should they approach? What are the key steps one needs to take or follow?
I think the first thing is, of course, to learn a programming language. I mean, there are these days some programming languages which are, like, for example, Python is one example, which is really, really used a lot which is easy to learn and which is very powerful. So if to anyone who is looking to get into software development or particularly data science, I would suggest learn Python. Spend some time, do some courses, you know, do some solve some online problems, simple things. And then I think what is very important is once you have some basic fundamentals to kind of to pick up a problem which you're passionate about or which you have come across in your daily life, and then use what you have learned and apply it to this problem. So build a simple, like a sort of simple project or something like that, using what you have learned in Python, or if you want another language also. I mean, Python is just an example. I think that would definitely, first of all, give you some skills, you will learn more. Plus at the end of it all, you will have a project which you can use to showcase what you have learned. These days, you know, it's a very important thing for if you are moving into a new field that you have a portfolio of projects which you can show to your potential employers. I think for that, this would be the right way to do it.
And one last thing is, what are the main challenges for someone who's moving abroad or even as in a job? How it is to be working and moving in different across different countries?
Yeah, I mean, there are a lot of challenges. I think the first challenge is definitely the language. If you're moving to somewhere like to Europe, let's say, most probably you might end up in a country where you don't speak the language. I think that's definitely one challenge. Which on the other hand, I mean, if you are working in software development or data science and all, I mean, at work, at least you would not face this challenge because most of the work is in English. Other things, of course, you know, paperwork, just, you know, settling down, finding a place, registering yourself with the different public departments and things like that. I think that's, of course, but that's again.
That's everywhere anyway. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a one-time thing.
Yeah.
That would be.
But what's your message? One thing is a challenge, but I also feel it's an opportunity, especially if they're moving for the first time, they should invest more time in picking up the language, because once it happens, as I think we all know, the opportunities becomes 100 times more, right?
Yeah, definitely. I would say if you have the chance, do try to invest some time to learn the language. I mean, when I moved here, I spent some time trying to learn German and it has helped me immensely. Without that, I think I would not have really sort of, okay, not integrated, but let's say I would have missed some experiences, I think. I think I would definitely recommend you to learn the language and spend some time.
That was a very interesting discussion with Dr. Paras. So any student out there or also profession, if you have any question about Germany, if you want to move to Germany, he's the right guy to get in touch with. I wish you all the very best and look forward to see you all soon in my next video.